imagination of nature is much greater than our own imagination. Every time we look out and discover new planets, and with Kepler, we've discovered over 2,000 new planets, all the old rules seem to go by the wayside. Planets exist where they shouldn't exist. Solar systems that we never imagined were possible are there. It indicates that basically almost anything that we can imagine is out there. And that's very good news because, first of all, you know, if we're looking for life elsewhere, the natural assumption was that most solar systems are like ours, with the rocky planets inside and the size of the Earth and the big giant gas giants outside. We've learned that that's not the rule. There are no rules, basically. Almost anything is possible. And for me, the fact that this rocky planet is 11 billion years old is probably the most exciting thing, because we didn't think rocky planets could form that early, because it takes a long time for the elements that now form you and I to build up. Every atom in your body and mine was inside stars that exploded, and it took a long time for those stars to create the iron and carbon and all the things that are important. And we didn't think 3 billion years after the Big Bang, or less than 3 billion years after the Big Bang, you could do that. So just think, there could be planets. Our Earth and our sun are only 4.5 billion years old.
Yeah.
There could be planets that are 7 billion years older. Imagine that. It's a lot of time for life to form.
You know, Lawrence, let's talk about this possibility of life in other places. Kepler-10c, close to the sun, well, closer, maybe too close, for humans to live there. But could life exist on it, or would temperature make that impossible?
Well, the temperature would make it impossible for life like we know it. And so, you know, we don't know what kinds of life can exist in the universe. We're kind of like, there's a famous thing in science where we say we're like drunks coming out of a bar. You know, you lose your keys. Where do you look for your keys? Underneath the lamppost. Why? Not because that's where you lost them, but that's the only place you're going to find them. So the first thing we do is think, well, let's look for planets like Earth with water about the same distance from a star like our sun, because we know that life can form because we're an example. But there could be lots more. We've discovered even on Earth, extremophiles, life seems to be quite robust and able to live in a huge number of different environments. So maybe there's exotic life on that planet. We don't know.
All right, let's talk about this colorful view of the universe to date, one of the most that NASA unveiled. I mean, it is beautiful. Let's see if we can get that up here. But picture contains, as what you're looking at there, this is amazing, 10,000 galaxies.
Wow.
Lawrence, put that into perspective for us.
Well, it's amazing to think, you know, there are 100 billion galaxies in the universe, and if you held up a dime-sized hole, you know, held your hand up at arm's length and looked at a dark spot in the sky, you could see 100,000 galaxies. There are 10,000 galaxies there. Each galaxy contains 100 billion stars. That means somewhere around basically 10,000 billion solar systems, possibly, and planets contained there. But the galaxies you're looking at are maybe 10 billion light years away. That means the light left them before our sun ever formed. And many of the stars in that image no longer exist. Our sun is going to die out in 5 billion years. Many of the stars in that picture no longer exist. And if there are any individuals on those galaxies, by the time they see pictures of our sun and our Milky Way, we won't exist any longer either. It's